Alecto Minerals has told investors this morning that it's making good progress on securing funding for its Matala project, which will be Zambia's first major standalone gold mine. With me on the line now is Chief Executive Mark Jones. Mark, good morning to you. Good to speak to you.
Morning. Yes, thanks for the opportunity.
It was initially hoped this would be wrapped up by September. What's been the holdup here, Mark?
I think you can put it down into one simple reality, which is that Alecto is a very small company. It has a small balance sheet, and therefore anyone who lends money to us is always going to be looking at how best they can secure their longer-term interest. And as we all know, banks only like lending money to people who have the financial security that they can pay it back. So the challenge for us has been not securing the interest, but finalizing things, and it's all a matter of making sure that we can convince the Chinese that the security that we'll be offering is acceptable to all parties.
So at what stage are you at the moment? Have we got any clearer idea yet on when it may be secured?
Yes, what's been happening is that the obvious security we can offer is a mortgage over the license. That particularly as we go through the build process and into production ends up being an immensely valuable asset, way over the value of the money that we'll be lending. Borrowing. So the key thing there is getting an institution in Zambia to recognise that, and we've identified institutions in that position, and of course getting the Zambian government to agree to it, which was the step that we announced today, which took place last month. So the key thing for us is to continue to work with the financial institutions we've identified in Zambia. We're in a process, these financial institutions, typically banks, aren't quick. They have their own levels of process, but we have no reason to believe that we won't be able to complete this within their timescales, which are never given to us, okay? When one buys a house and looks for a mortgage, and someone says, well, you can get approval maybe in 4 to 6 weeks, it's not unusual for that to be extended. I'd like to think that we can wrap this up before the end of the year, but if I promised that and we didn't do so, then I'd be pillared again. So we're comfortable that we're on track for success. We're not able to predict specifically when.
Given your size, Mark, did you find it a little more challenging than first expected to secure financing?
The answer is we were pleasantly surprised with all the initial discussions with anyone we spoke to. Everyone sees the merits of the project we have. It has low execution risk. Politically and socially, we are wonderfully placed within Zambia. So the initial discussions we had with all parties have given us a belief that we can complete this effectively. And then sadly, we also believed more timelessly, and hence our target of end of September was one we believe was realistic, but we breached that as we know. We are a small company, and until we complete this transaction, we'll remain small. We're obviously trying to keep the shareholders positive about where we'll be in the future. We will have a very different balance sheet as and when we complete this transaction. Sadly, it's not before the process because it would have been so much easier. The board's conscious of what we need to do. Our strategy is clear. We're not wavering from it. We've had wonderful chances to move our West African assets into a position of potential prosperity being paid for by joint venture partners. We know we need to get into production in Southern Africa. Zambia's our obvious first-time focus, but let me try and get people to understand, and it hopefully comes through in all that we've said. We will not just be a single project company in the future, and Matala is going to be a very important part of our future, but not the only part.
Well, look, the funding niggles to one side for a moment. It's been quite an impressive year for you. You've achieved a lot within 12 months.
We like to think so. I guess at the end of the day, one has to be realistic that the only way that the market puts you into a position of either having succeeded or not is based on your market capitalization. And we haven't achieved tremendous uplift in that area at all. And that's something which, whilst it cannot be my primary focus, because you know ultimately if I'm able to deliver on all we do, that becomes a guaranteed change anyway. but it has to be an important focus, and I would hate to think that shareholders will think that we're not understanding the reality of where we are. So, yes, we believe from an activity point of view, from a material completion of process point of view, we've done some fantastic things this year. But until the market confirms that, I think we, as a board, realise that it's not a job done yet.
Good to speak to you, Mark. As always, thanks for the time.
It's a pleasure. Thanks for the opportunity.